Hi guys, welcome to another episode of It Lurks Below. My name is Wilfred, and throughout the last couple of months, I've been doing quite a number of videos for this game, designed and created by Mr. David Bravik, who's also the founder of Diablo 1 and 2, Helgoland, as well as Marvel Heroes. So I've done, during the closed beta, I've shared the Bard, Cleric, Necromancer, and right now, Early Access, I'm doing an Enchanter. I've also got a guide for you guys to kind of kickstart the whole journey, how to start up your base, home base, so that you could get all the plants and farming sorted upfront, and then focus on the content below. So I've done that. I hope that is a useful video. Also, some of the gameplay to introduce to you how the Enchanter plays like, or in general, how this game plays like in the first kind of like 10 level or so. So I've done that too. In this video, I'd like to talk a little bit about the stats, the attributes, crafting, some of the stuff that I have not shown you guys yet, and something that is really core to the game, because I've been showing a lot of gameplay. It doesn't really talk too much about what's behind the scene, what decision you have to make, and so on. So this is my base, by the way, and I've got a couple of levels here. From a stat-wise perspective, I think I'll just start with the stats first. I think that's easier to articulate. So there are, the character has a level, which is the yellow bar here. As you gain the XP, you then level up to next level. So that is pretty much any ARPG or any RPG kind of concept. There's another bar called the survival XP, which would help you to as you do things like farming, as you get seed, you plant seed, make food, whatnot, what have you. Mining? You gain a survival kind of like points that you can level the rank as well. Now I'm rank 18. So the higher rank it is, the easier it becomes. So there's a certain kind of progression. You start with some kind of farming or mining that is kind of tedious and take a while to get things done. But as you gain more experience, the whole journey become a little bit smoother and sort of like, it become a lot better in that sense. So that's one. There are other stats as well, like attack power, vitality, intelligence, as well as wisdom. And now I believe that, depending on the class that you choose, there are some base stat that will increase. Like for example, I'm an enchanter, I actually get vitality as well as intelligence as I level up to a certain level, I think. But you can also make decision as in like what kind of points that you like to add. So every time you level up one, you get the possibility of assigning the power, or sorry, the points to one of the attributes. So I have already leveled 13 times, now I'm level 14. So I've assigned everything into attack power. So I believe the rest of it come from the vanilla kind of like class that give it to you, 1 and 2. Now, how do you decipher all these points? I'm still experimenting, because in reality, you really need to play the character long enough to understand what works for that character. Because like, for example, I remember for a cleric, stats like armor actually helps in a different way. You can convert that into like DPS and so on. So, but then you only get to have a sense of it after you have gone through that journey of knowing the class. Then if you don't, then you probably have to go along with some very conservative kind of approach. Like for me, I've done various kind of things. I've put everything into vitality before. I've got a mix of vitality, attack power. I have a mix of attack power, vitality, intelligence, and wisdom. But this time around, I would like to go full force on DPS. I'll tell you why in just a bit. So attack power, it is nothing but a multiplier to your flat damage. So it started off with, I think, every point you get, you put in, you get 5% of it. So I think, yeah, that's there about for 5% per point that you get in. It's linear, no diminishing return. So your basically your attack kind of like power, the power hands, we just scale up accordingly. Vitality will give you the health, so the higher the vitality, the higher the health point is, and the longer you would last in a battle, of course. Intelligence governs your mana pool, so the more intelligence you have, for the bigger the pool of mana. Why? Because your wand, whether I can do it now or not, I don't know, can't quite remember. Okay, so your wand will actually run out, and then after that it'll recharge. So there's a recharge time. Now the number of course the mana will govern the how long you can hold the trigger, and the wisdom is the one that would shorten the duration of the recharge time, so make it a lot faster to recharge. Now why is it important? Well, the higher the weapon, like this is an eye level 9, so I believe there is a formula towards the recharge time. So the higher the eye level it is, the longer the recharge time would be. So it may be worthwhile at end game to actually look into wisdom as well. And that is just one of those things. I need to experiment a little bit on what works for me and what doesn't, especially for this class, which is the Enchanter. Armor is the damage mitigation, and if you don't mind, let me just pick some berry first, because berry kind of like they get rotten quite fast, so I need to just get some berry because I need to cook some pies in just a bit. But back to the whole introduction of the game is that there is armor that is to mitigate damage against you. There's also things that you can't really see here. Is the I believe is the resist as well, because I've got a ring that I've crafted that give me the resistance to damage against various kind of the damage type: magic, fire, cold, lightning, and poison. I think magic, if I'm going right, because I've been talking to Mr. Bravik in Discord as well. If I got it right, magic is the very plain vanilla kind of like a base damage. Like, you know, I think whatever, meaning that if there is no fire, no cold, no lightning, no poison, it means that it is basically magic. Fire will have a burn effect, I believe. Cold will freeze you. Lightning stuns you, and poison slow you, if I got it right as well. I think out of these four, fire and poison will have a damage over time against you. Yeah, so that is how, I mean, if you play a lot of ARPG, it should come as no surprise, this sort of like design of it. So you have a base that your damage always have a max and min. It depends on what weapon are you equipping. I think let me see, now it's 1, so now it's of course like 61 103, which is what this weapon is. This weapon is 37 63. How does it get from 67 How does it get from 37, 63 into 61, 103? Is when your attack power come in the picture, and whatever that stats that affect the some of the stats that you have in your gear may increase the minimum damage or maximum damage as well. So that's how the damage is being derived. The moment you rotate out from it, like number 3, which is the axe itself, the pickaxe, then the damage will get lower as well. So that's how they display the DPS of it. You could actually work out DPS as well. There is also a firing rate is being governed by the I believe it's the attack speed of it, if I'm not wrong. So of course the higher your attack speed, the higher the rate is. Then the this one is the magic. Yeah, so this one has no kind of like other additional additional, let me just eat something first, additional function to it. There's no burn, there's no slow by person, there's no stun by lightning, nor there is freeze on the cold. So it's a one that I think I should change it somehow. When I look into it, I say, yeah, maybe I should change it. So that's how the stack works. And there's also a critical hit as well. Then unless you gear for it, it's 0%. And the I'll talk about the gear in just a bit. But there are other things like in an ancient item. I'll show you in just a bit how to augment this figure here. All right, now gear wise it's kind of interesting. Now crafting is kind of a rich topic. I'm not going to go through everything in one shot, but what it does is that it has the tools, like various kind of tools that you have. It has the material, which is like fertilizer. You can have like various kind of like bar or whatnot. As you level up, you get more here. There are magical stuff as well, like the scroll of identification, that is to identify any items that unidentified, I guess, and various kind of ring that you have, that you can do, and ring will consume a rune to create. And then you have the armor as well. The armor is very interesting. The iron armor has no socket, but the copper one has. So armor will have the armor value, like 8 here, 15, as well as, I think as well as life, if I'm not wrong, hang on a second, as well as the hit point, I think. Yep, hit point as well. So it does, but it is like a vanilla, kind of like a basic set with no stats to it. So it is as good as any you mine for the ore, and after that you create the items. Now, how to make it magical is through some of this, like crystal here. So the crystal here that is basically loot from everywhere else on the ground. It will increase your, like for example, this one increase my hit point from 572 into say 745. So you augment the gear the way that you want. Like for example, because as a level, I put everything into attack power, and hence I need to balance it with the vitality or any defensive kind of like stats. So as I gear my so-called as I put in my gear, my crystal, it is of my interest to actually look for things that give me hit point. So I balance it out between what is being fixed that I cannot change versus things that I could change. If I find that I'm enough hit point, then why I will swap one of these out, like this one, maybe I swap it out, then I lose like 45 hit point, but then I may gain something else. Also notice that all of these are crystal, you can destroy them, and when you destroy them you recover something called the crystal shards. So crystal shard again is for crafting, you can craft it for runes. So I jump to runes here. Right now I only have 4 runes, but I think there are ways to create higher tiers runes. So various kind of runes will require the crystal shard, which is by destroying the crystal, of course. How intuitive. You can do cooking as well, there are various kind of cooking. Some of them is for, like this one is for health regen as well, so slowly heal you for 2 minutes, so that's nice. Then you have torch, you have leather, you have other like functionality stuff like forge, bait and stuff like that. There are blueprint that help you build all these NPC, one per map. After that you can have all these different blocks and so on. So crafting itself is very interesting. The gear wise is something that you would need to like augment with the right crystal. As you level up, as you go down deeper, you will find different material. So I can't remember what's the next stage after copper. I think it's material. I can't quite remember. I think it's material. I think. I think next one is material. So material is another one that requires different type of crystal as well. So it's kind of interesting as you collect and get all the crystal. So these are the four items that you could actually collect. It's a lot of like interesting itemization as well, unique gear and so on. Last but not the least, of course, a ring, and there's a second ring. When I'm at level 25, I can have a second ring, and I have a hat as well, as I get another blueprint for a vendor to, it's a vanity, and there's a pet as well, by the way. So I hope that gives you some idea of what the itemization is like. But that's not really the end of it, because let me collect some tomatoes, the tomato expired in 4 minutes time, so I tend to just talk too much, and after that I forget that I need to harvest those things. Fantastic, perfect timing. So this is the let me just eat something first. So survival thingy, so I would like to show it to you what this means as well. This is really really exciting stuff. Now during the closed beta, a lot of people feedback, and I think in Steam you can read the review or discussion, people are concerned this is like any other farming game, it's like very boring, and there's no progression. So because of that, Mr. Brevet actually came up with a new like system to help us to progress in terms of all the survival kind of like a skill and so on. So for example, you could the crops last longer in the world before rotting, like this one here expired in 37 minutes, before that it wasn't, and after that you can have 50% more, so so it lasts longer, you can go out and fight longer, and you come back and still can get the stuff. There are things like get more seed when you get from a crop kind of thing, so that is kind of useful. There are things that you could actually try fertilizer, perfect kind of crops. But the reality is that I think this is a little bit of waste right now, but I think this is getting somewhere quite a fantastic thing. I think it's to do with alchemy, if I'm not wrong. But anyway, that's I can double stack all my crops. I can combine some of the tools like axe and hoe together instead of swapping the two of them. It's kind of convenient. Then the pick crops last longer, because once you pick something like the the berry that I pick, it only lasts like, you know, maybe 15 minutes before I have to cook it and do something about it. So let me just check all these things first. So that is the cooking part, the farming part, but there's also the cooking part whereby you can have different kind of like a warm berry, comfort chili, or I think an energy bar. If you don't like to sleep, some people don't like the fact that you have to sleep all the time. You can have an energy bar or coffee if you want to, or bread that will sustain you in a pretty good way. There are things like different kind of acts that you can do, like mithril, like adamantine. So and now you can double stack your or double stack your bars, and then after that you have an extra chance to orbs and so on. So you know there's a progression there. As you gain more level, things become easier. And of course there's one called alchemy that is work in progress, but I guess it's something that you could actually do to create some potion, a health potion, health potion, or whatever potion that is required. All right. So now I'm just scratching the surface here because there's a lot of thing going on with the game. I can't really do it justice by just doing one video on this one without playing through it. But the last thing I would like to talk about, beside the guns, of course. Oh, by the way, the wand. Beside the wand is that, let me just show you the bank as well. So there are different kind of wands. Some of them, like for example, this one is a poison one. Some of them can be like the glowing, whatever. But all in all, I've seen different kind of wand does different things. Some will multi-shot, like a spray. Some of them will bounce across the area. So, if you are at some very hard to do area, like the anti-terrorism kind of thing in the urban warfare kind of thing, you have this reflective mirror and see how to shoot the bullet somewhere. I don't know. But it's one of those things that you could play around with, a lot of wine option. But the last thing I would like to talk about is the ancient items, because that is very defining. When you start off as a level one bard or enchanter or level one cleric or level one whatever, it's all the same, because there's no ancient item yet. You started at the like a blank slate there. I think some other game does it the same as well, like Titan Quest, I believe, when you start off brand new. You can't really pick a class at first, but as you gain level up, then you gain more ability. So this is exactly the same as well. I started off with something called the Jade Skull of the Third Eye once I leveled to 5. So essentially what it does is that it stun the enemy around me, so that's cool. And it synergizes with the next one, is that once you stun them, you have a crit hit chance. So 60% crit hit right now at this rank is pretty awesome, because you can see a lot of like red text that come out. These are class specific one. You can rank up using gold, and it costs quite a fair bit, but I think all in all it's worth it. But you can also have a chance to loot ancient. Now these are being handed to me. As I level to 5, I get this one. Level to 10, I got this one. So I think level to 15, I got another one. And eventually I have to pick and choose which one I want to be become my build. But I can also pick something that is not my class, like this one, the Divina. If I remember correctly, this is a cleric kind of like ancient. So the good thing is that you can actually pick and mix. Like I could have a necromancer ancient item as well to augment my build, if that makes sense to me. The only catch is that you cannot rank it up. So 500 hit point is what you have, and you cannot go further than that. Unlike if you are the class like cleric, then you can do something about it. All right. I think all in all, once you get a hang of it, you have a lot of ancient items here. Some of them this is a passive item. Some of them is active, and you just have to create your build, and that's where the fun comes in. So I think that's all today. I do not want to overstretch it into too many information overload. But all in all, this is what this game is about. It's a lot of fun, a lot of depth to it, and I haven't really talked about the portal as well. And my service has been invaded, so now I just need to deal with my service invader. I'll see you next time. Goodbye.